One of the reasons why Final Cut Pro is such a great editing software is because of the speed at which you can pump out quality videos. But have you set up your Final Cut Pro to help you achieve superhero speed? The first thing you can do is utilize this tab to your advantage. For photos, create an album in your phone and maybe put all the logos or PNG images that you use for your videos in there. Then after you connect your phone and import, you'll see that by going into photos, you have that album with all the logos and stuff that you use. For the music tab, every time you download a song from Artlist or wherever, make sure it makes its way into the music application. Usually you can do this by just clicking the song when you download it. When you do that, you'll notice that all your songs are in that tab, so you have quick and easy access to music for your projects. For Apple TV, open the application and drag all the overlays, film grain, stock video, whatever you use in your projects to this application, and they will automatically show up whenever you hop into Final Cut Pro. And lastly, set up your sound effects folder so you have access to all of your purchased and downloaded sound effects directly within Final Cut Pro. What you'll do is make a main folder with all of your sound effects, right click and hit Make Alias. This is basically a folder that's attached to your main sound effect folder, so if you add more sound effects to the main folder, the alias folder will get them too. Copy this by pressing Command C. Then go to your hard drive, usually Macintosh, go to Library, Audio, Apple Loops, Apple, Final Cut Pro Sound Effects, and press Command V to paste that alias folder that you copied. Now you'll have all of your sound effects easily accessible within the software. The next trick to help you become a speedy FCP superhero is to reassign important functions to specific keys. I honestly think this is one of the greatest things I've done to help make me a faster editor. If I want to set my clip or clips to automatic speed for slow motion, normally you'd have to go into this retime menu and hit automatic speed, but I have this set to option forward slash. If I want to make a cut, I just press B. If I want to lower or raise my audio, all I do is hit minus or plus. If I want to solo select a clip, I just press C, which is nice because it's right next to the default key to disable or mute. So they're opposites in a way that are right next to each other on the keyboard. And something that I changed recently because of a subscriber who suggested it, all I do is hit G to trim start and H to trim end. The default shortcut to trim start and end is normally option left or right bracket, but I found that changing this trim function to G and H has made my life so much easier. It may seem like you're only shaving off a little bit of time, but that time really adds up and it really will make your life easier when editing. Here's a quick breakdown of how you can set these up. Let me preface this by saying though, if you wanna just download my custom keyboard shortcut so you don't have to set this up manually, I'll leave a link in the description. You'll press Option Command K to bring up your keyboard shortcut editor. You'll click this drop-down menu, select Duplicate, type in the name you want, then you'll use the search bar to find those functions to set them to a new key. So we'll type in Solo to change the Solo Select function, select this, and hit the key that you would like to change it to, which for us is the C key. Then reassign and delete the previous key if you want. You don't have to delete it, of course, you could have two keys with the same function. And just repeat this process for all of the functions that we went over. Just a heads up that doing this does take the spot of certain functions, but none that I feel are more important than the ones we're replacing them with. Let me pause real quick to tell you about a total gold mine of a service if you're creative. Today's sponsor, Envato Elements. Here is why a subscription with them is worth it. Envato Elements has 55 million assets that you can download. That is a number big enough to make your brain spin. It has Final Cut Pro and Motion 5 plugins, like tons of different transitions, really cool animated templates, titles, and more. You can create better sound design with their large list of sound effects, as well as royalty-free music. Download their stock videos and photos for whatever your creative mind can come up with, and use their huge list of fonts and motion graphics for whatever you'd like. You can find everything on there, and I mean everything. The best part is you can download as much as you want, unlimited downloads on all of their creative assets, and what's cool is that they offer a 7-day free trial so you can see for yourself that it's worth it. Use the link in the description and you'll get 50% off when you select the annual subscription. Become a better creative and join the Envato Elements family. The next thing you can do to edit at superhero speed is to set up different workspaces to speed up your workflow and make your FCP interface just look better in a short amount of time. So check this out. Let's say when I color grade, I usually have my video scopes up by pressing Command 7, I usually go with a two-up layout with a vector scope on top and a luma waveform on bottom. I'll usually start with my color wheels, so I'll press Command 6 and make sure my color wheels are selected. Maybe I'll make the scopes a little smaller so my viewport is bigger. I'll push down the timeline because we don't really need to have that big when color grading. And this, I would say, is my ideal color grading setup. Instead of having to make FCP look like this every time, which would take way too long to set up, go to Window, Workspaces, Save Workspace As, and I'll label this Color Grading Workspace. Now, every time I go into my workspaces and hit this, it'll set up FCP exactly how I want it. Some of you are probably thinking, yeah, but I don't really like to color grade, so that's not useful. But there are tons of other options for useful layouts. Maybe one for editing audio, one for importing, organizing, and keywording media, and even just a standard workspace for editing. Last trick to make you a speedy Final Cut Pro superhero is to use another one of the things that makes FCP an amazing editing software, and that is keywording and smart collections. Consider these like file cabinets and sticky notes for your media. Let's say you just imported a bunch of footage and you're stressed at how much footage you actually have. You're not sure how you're gonna remember what is what and where certain parts are. Absolutely start doing this. So select clips or parts of clips that maybe all have a, say, specific motion. Press Command K, type in that motion, and hit Enter. Pretend what you just did is placed a sticky note on those clips or sections of clips. Let's say you have clips that you'd like to use for a sad moment. Select those clips, hit Command K, type in sad or whatever, and press Enter. Now, when you open up your event, you'll see the keyword icon with all those keywords that you made. They're basically folders that have all of the clips or parts of clips that you sticky noted with those words. So when you click on the folder, you have those specific clips all nice and neat and ready to use. Smart collections are like master folders. They allow you to incorporate multiple folders of specific sticky notes and other settings in one master folder. So if you hit File, New Library Smart Collection, and double click the setting icon, you can create a smart collection of any clips or parts of clips that maybe have been selected as, say, favorites, are unused, and let's say have markers on them. You can create a smart collection of clips that have specific keywords, were shot on a certain date, and let's say are synchronized. This library obviously doesn't have enough categorized media for that one to work, but you get the point. Smart collections help keep you even more organized by allowing you to access really specific footage faster. This will undoubtedly help you to create projects quicker and ultimately turn you into a Final Cut Pro superhero.